Hey guys, so, have kind of interesting day, so I decided to film it. First, I just want to show you how crazy my room has become. So this is my luggage for Florida. Pretty much everything's packed except for this few stuff on top. Okay. And then, this is for tonight. All this stuff is for tonight. Separate pile, and that's what I'm wearing. This pile is for the week I have to go back to Windsor from Florida for our brother's wedding, so have to have that ready. And this stuff is my carry-on. Crazy piles everywhere, and I've run out of clothes, so this is pretty much all I have left. You guys also haven't seen, I added this shelf. See, you guys saw me put this shelf in that picture, and I put this shelf for South Africa. So there's me, Tom, and Charlie, with animals behind us. I believe there's zebras. And then Kelly and me, Charlie and me and all the kids, well, not all the kids, but some of the kids from Morningstar. And me, Charlie, and Tom again. And then the whole group with our safari. And then an elephant. And then Shannon and I. There's a reflection. Shannon and I. Oh yeah, I also collect, like, each place I want to have, like, little animals. So I got the elephant from South Africa, and I also have a armadillo from Argentina. So yeah. So right now, we are going to get ready for tonight. And by getting ready means I'm shaving and getting a haircut. That way it won't come with anymore. I know, I kind of look homeless. Horless? Homeless. I look homeless. So I'm gonna get this. Look how gross that is. It's wet. It's not grease or anything, it's wet hair. I just had a shower. And then I'm gonna shave this. The main reason why I'm getting a haircut and why I'm shaving, not only because of tonight, but also because when I go to Florida, they have strict guidelines on how you can look while working. So, alright, let's begin. So what do you guys think? I left a little mustache here, but I'm probably going to shave it off. What do you guys think about the mustache? Should I keep it? Because I am allowed to have a mustache while in Florida, like while working. I just can't grow it while I'm there. Like, it has to be there when I go. I'm probably gonna shave it. I don't like mustaches on me. I think they're weird. Normally I don't have facial hair. I like to shave it just because it gets really itchy and it bugs me. So the only reason why it's that long is because it can't be that, like, I can't have facial hair for a full year. So I just wanted to grow it out a little bit. So yeah, but I'm not done shaving because I have to still straight edge, whatever, razor blade. I just use my electric razor to trim it down, and now I'm just gonna shave it. Phase one complete. Partial not becoming a homeless person, complete. So, that's shaved. The only thing I liked about it is it hides. They're not pimples, they're ingrown hairs. It's kind of gross, but everyone gets them. Or pimples or ingrown hairs or whatever. So at least mine are well hidden behind this. But now I have to deal with it. But part two of this phase is getting my hair. So I'm gonna go get ready and do that.
Holy crap, it's windy out. It's pretty nice out.
other than the fact that it's windy, which I don't mind. Fun fact, when I shower and wash my hair and don't put a hat on, my hair goes poofy like this. It's all poofy and gross and don't like it. And we are cutting it in T-minus 5 seconds. Alright, so my hair is all cut, nice and short. My faux hawk, as usual, I guess. So I went to this new place called Trendset. Actually, it's probably not new, I'm just new to the town. And had an apprentice, Nikki, cut my hair. First time she ever did a faux hawk. So, $10. Not bad. I gave her a $5 tip. Works out. Alright, so still windy as heck out. Right now, I'm on my way to, upside down, mail Emily. Remember Emily from previous video? Or, like, not previous, like, last one, but before the South African videos, I went to Emily's. So I'm mailing her her birthday. Her birthday's Sunday on Halloween. So, yeah, that's that. This is my second attempt trying to mail it. Tried once, got one-third of the way there and forgot my credit card, so, yeah. Such a nice day out, although it's really windy.
Is this your new vlogging
camera? This is my new vlogging camera. You like it? Pretty awesome.
Peter loves them, especially when they're all like all over the place and on a computer that has really crappy sound. It's like,
yeah.
And I'm like, I'm gonna go
take a video. Why are you taking pictures of flowers?
Why don't you buy them?
They're not
going to
last
till
you
come
first. You can
hang them up and dry them and then take them to the florist and say this is what I want. Okay, yeah, or I can stick them to the shoe. Frugal.
Hello?
Hey, Gus.
Hi.
We're missing all the bass.
Maybe you should have gone into Walmart.
Did you know about this place?
Wild Water and Wheels.
Well, there are like little zoo animals in the middle of it too.
I like my car. My keys should be in there somewhere.
Okay, this one.
How are you guys doing?
Go, Bruce.
What?
I don't know.
Pumpkin patch.
Keep racing this one.
And go.
It's usually the size I buy. It takes two people to load it into the car. It costs $50. And then I never carve them. I miss my parents. There you go. There's your pumpkin.
This one has like a flat side that's not ugly.
That's good.
Ugly ones are the best ones. Like, you get the not the bumpy one and make it a witch.
Alright, well, that's a witch.
Why do you then? Oh no, I just go for small ones.
Actually, this one's a gourd.
I'll just paint it on.
I'll take that pear. Apple.
We probably should have gotten a carving kit while we were at
that's the next quest.
I'm gonna call it everywhere.
Chris will be the next YouTube sensation.
The next Justin Bieber. There you go. Right there.
Okay, well, is this your first vehicle with Onstar?
It sure is.
Okay, well, welcome to the Onstar family. people. The purpose of today's call is for me to go over Onstar's features with you, just to make sure that you are aware of the features and you do enjoy your Onstar subscription.
Okay.
Now, the first feature I'd like to go over with you is our automatic crash response, which is our most important feature. With the automatic crash response, when you're if your vehicle is ever involved in a crash, your cobot will automatically send an alert to an advisor, and we will be immediately connected to your vehicle. So even if you're injured or unable to respond, we can still get emergency services to your GPS location.
Okay.
Okay? Great. Now if you'll take a look at your rearview mirror, you will notice that there are three OnStar buttons. That red OnStar button is your emergency button. That is the button that you will press if you ever need police, fire, or emergency assistance.
Alright.
Okay.
Yep.
Now the next service I'd like to go over with you is your OnStar Vehicle Diagnostics. Now with the OnStar Vehicle Diagnostics, when OnStar can automatically run hundreds of diagnostic reports for your vehicle, and we check